Assalamu alaikum, guys. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Camilla, and in today's video I am going to be talking about the tension between Somalis and Somali Bantus. This is a video I have been meaning to make for a long time now, but I paused on it because I was not sure if it was the appropriate time. But lately I have been getting some crazy comments under my TikTok video, and I just feel like it's the right time to do it, to come sit here, address this, and really talk about what's going on, because it's something that needs to be talked about. Before I get deeply into the topic, I want to give you guys a brief history on who Somali Bantus are. Somali Bantus are not ethnic Somalis. We were brought to Somalia during the Arab slave trade. We settled there and made it our home, but Somali Bantus endured a lot in Somalia. We basically went through the same thing African Americans went through in America. We were dehumanized, women raped, male beaten, children thrown to the curb. Anything horrible you can think of, we were put through. A lot of Somalis do not like to acknowledge this fact, and it's the same thing white Americans do to black Americans. Many white people deny the crazy things they put black people through during slavery, and it's the same thing happening here. Knowing this, it's fair to say many Somalis have a better than thou mentality. A lot believe their looks give them superiority over Bantus, to a point that they don't even consider us Somalis, which is false, because Somali Bantus, whether you like to accept it or not, are Somalis. Our parents were born in Somalia, they were raised in Somalia, we follow a Somali culture, eat Somali food, listen to Somali music, wear Somali clothing, speak a Somali language. We are as Somali as it can get, and if you don't want to accept that fact, that's between you and whoever you want to take it up with, because it won't be us. It's also very evident that Somali Bantus and Somalis have different features. As Bantus, we have Afrocentric features. As you can see, my nose is bigger, my lips are bigger. Whereas ethnic Somalis, they have Eurocentric features, slimmer nose, softer hair. And I cannot help but think this is where the hate and the animosity towards Bantus strives from, is the fact that we have different features. I feel like Somalis do believe that they look better and are better than Somali Bantus because of these features that they have. But baby, we as Bantus, we are highly proud of our Afrocentric features. I love my big nose. I love my big lips. People pay for these features, so how could I ever hate these features? Are you kidding me? This is pride. I take pride in my big nose, my big lips. So there is no hatred or jealousy towards you guys when it comes to that field. But I feel like you guys think we are jealous of you guys for your features. Or maybe you guys want us to be jealous of you guys for your features. And it makes no sense, because I have never looked at a Somali person, an ethnic Somali person, and thought to myself, damn, I wish I looked like that. Are you kidding me? No, you are beautiful. You got that. But I am beautiful too in my Afrocentric features. And I know many of you guys are probably thinking, why are you making it about features? Why you keep talking about features? It's because it has always been about features. The only reason other ignorant Somalis don't consider Bantu Somalis is because of our features. If we had softer hair, slimmer nose, or looked like their standards of what a Somali person should look like, they would have taken us as Somalis and would not have questioned our Somaliness. The reason they question it is because they see that we look different than them, and that's due to features. So I'm sorry if it makes you uncomfortable that I keep talking about features, but I have to, because it has always been about features. And you know what's so ironic to me is the fact that many Somalis hate Arabs because they believe Arabs think that they're better than them, and they believe Arabs see them as abid, which means slaves. But Somalis do the same thing that they claim Arabs do to them, to Somali Bantus. That's such a hypocrite move, because you hate Arabs for the same things you're doing to your own kind. It makes no sense. You guys claim you are oppressed by Arabs. Arabs are evil people. Arabs are terrible people. They think they are better than us. This, that, this, that. But you are doing the same thing, probably worse, to Somali Bantus. You don't like to be on the other end of the spectrum, but you do the same thing to us and that makes it okay? How can you be the same people that you claim to hate? Because in my eyes, there's no difference between those ignorant Arabs and you. And y'all know whenever I make videos like this, I always pull up with the receipts because many Somalis do not like to believe that Somalis can be ignorant or we have ignorant people in our community. So let me show you guys the ignorance that I have been receiving and what I'm talking about in this video. This girl said, "You don't give a F because you're a Jarir. Naya, you forgot you used to be a slave cleaning for us." The fact that somebody could sit here and brag about such embarrassment is crazy to me. And you are a Muslim. God sees, hears everything, and he is aware of all. Trust me, the treatment Somali Bantus have endured in Somalia, the enslavement, our haq will be given to us on the day of judgment. The people who would put us through all that trouble, you will pay for it on the day of judgment. God will hold you accountable for the actions and the maltreatment you put us through. That's not forgotten. We have forgave and moved on earth. But trust me, on the day of judgment, the creator, your creator, will question you for those things. So I promise you that is not something you should be proud of. The fact that you're bragging about slaving people, embarrassing. Your own people are that, embarrassing. Next comment. This person said, "They were brought to Somalia so they can clean and cook for real Somali people. They're maids. They don't even look like Somalis. They're such ugly creatures." The creature part cut off, but I'm assuming that's what he was going to say. Again, embarrassing. The fact that you guys really sit here and brag about this is mind-blowing to me. Mind-blowing. How can you brag about slavery? Do white people even do that? I don't even think white people do that. So yeah, worse than white people at this point. Oof, like, what the heck? And this person said, "Why do Bantus don't like to claim their original country, Malawi and Tanzania?" First of all, I was born in Kenya. If I was to claim anything, I would claim Kenya first. But the reason I don't claim Kenya is because I don't know anything about Kenya. As I mentioned in the beginning of this video, as Somali Bantus, we follow a Somali culture, speak a Somali dialect, eat Somali food. We breed Somalia. We don't know much about Kenya for us to be claiming Kenya. Why don't you claim Kenya? You were probably born in Kenya too. Many Somalis were born in Kenya because our country was not so great and we had to escape to Kenya for refuge. You don't get to tell us what we should and should not claim. If we say we are Somali, leave it at that. I am not claiming Tanzania. I was never born in Tanzania. And I don't even know what Malawi is. So I am not going to claim a country I know nothing about to please you, to make you feel comfortable, because you don't see me as Somali. That's a you problem. Deal it with yourself. Because to me, I am Somali and I will continue telling people that. Who's gonna stop me? You guys have so much balls on social media, but you guys will never say this to a Somali Bantu person in real life. I promise you, you're not gonna have the same energy in real life. This internet thugging is not cute and y'all need to cut it. It's embarrassing. If I was to sit here and show you guys all the ignorant comments left on my TikTok videos, you will be shocked. You will be shocked because I'd be shocked. And I shouldn't, because this is something that has been going on for such a long time. But they never failed to shock me still. But I'm not going to give them that energy that they want. I'm not going to read every comment. Those three were the ones that kind of struck a nerve. Especially the ones that were taking pride in enslaving Somali Bantus. That was utterly disgusting to me. So I have to show you guys. And this is a argument many Somalis like to use, that Somali Bantus don't even claim Somalia, that they rather claim Tanzania or Kenya. Why do you think that is? Somali Bantus claim Kenya, Tanzania, or the next neighborhood because they have been bullied out of being or claiming Somalia. Who wants to claim Somalia when you're constantly being told you are not Somali, you are not Somali, you are not Somali, you are Jarir, you are Mado, you are Jarir, you are Mado. The amount of ignorant comments that are pushed towards Somali Bantu's way, you cannot be mad at them for not claiming Somalia. And many Somali Bantus also don't want to claim Somalia because of the dark history our people were put through. And you also cannot shame them for that. We are constantly being reminded that we were slaves, as you just saw. We are constantly being told we were the help. So you cannot be mad at people for not wanting to claim Somalia when that's the treatment that they are receiving from ignorant people. But to my Somali Bantu brothers and sisters, do not let these ignorant people push you away or scare you off into claiming Somalia. You are as Somali as they are. Our parents were born and raised in Somalia, as I mentioned. We have no choice but to claim Somalia. When you don't claim Somalia, you are letting them win, and do not let that happen. Do not let these ignorant people convince you of otherwise. You are Somali. They will never say the things that they say online to you in person, so don't even worry about it. If they ask you what you are, tell them you are Somali because you are Somali. Stop claiming Kenya and Tanzania as a safe haven. Unless you were born and raised in Kenya or Tanzania and you speak Swahili and you know a lot about that country, stop claiming it. It's embarrassing. This happened to me once, true story. I was one of those who were bullied into not claiming Somalia too, so I started claiming Kenya because I was born and raised in Kenya. But one time this guy approached me and he was like, "Where are you from?" And I told him I'm Kenyan. So he started speaking to me in Swahili and I froze. I don't speak Swahili, so I'm looking at him like, "What did you say?" And he's looking at me like, "You don't speak the language?" And I'm there like, "No, I don't." And now I'm giving him a brief history about my family and where I'm actually from. I'm telling him, "Oh, my parents are actually Somali, but I was born in Kenya." And that man is telling me that I should just claim Somalia then. That's embarrassing. Like, that encounter was so embarrassing for me. Claiming Kenya when I don't even speak Swahili. I have never done that again. From this day forward, I claim Somali. And I claim it proudly because at least I can interact with Somali people in Somali language when they speak to me. I speak a dialect of Somali. Many people don't consider Afmaimai Somali, but Afmaimai is Somali. Afmaimai is a dialect of Somali. There's two main dialects in the Somali language. That's Afmaha and Afmaimai. If you don't know this basic information, are you even Somali? Ask yourself that question. I titled this video, "Are Somalis Racist?" because that was meant as a question. That was a question that I was asked once upon a time. And I wanted to use that question as the title of this video, mainly just to bring people here so they can hear what I have to say. And secondly, I would say that's subjective. I personally do not think black people can be racist, but I will say Somali people are colorist and they are very ignorant. This is not all of Somalis, obviously. But there are a huge portion of Somalis who are very ignorant, colorist, and just disgusting people. It is no secret that many Somalis do think they're better than black people. You show this for yourself. You prove this for yourself. The amount of hate comments Somalis leave on other people who are not Somalis comment section is embarrassing. I have seen it myself, and people can even come out and speak for themselves. I had friends who are coming up to me like, "Damn, your people are racist as hell." My friends are not Somali, but they see it. You guys publicly leave ignorant comments in a public platform where anybody can see and read the comments for themselves. So if somebody wants to label Somalis as racist, I can't say nothing about that. You prove that you are colorist. You prove that you are ignorant. You do the work for yourself. So I personally cannot answer that question. Like I said, it's subjective. If you think black people can be racist and want to classify Somalis as racist, that is on you. I will say that it's not all Somalis. Not all Somalis are ignorant, racist, colorist, whatever you want to call it. It is 2021. At this point, you are choosing to be ignorant. Seeking knowledge is part of being Muslim. So why don't you get off the internet? Why don't you get off TikTok and go seek some knowledge? I hope this video opens up conversations that we need to have. It is time we become one Somalia, and it is time we respect each other. Our parents are much more ignorant than we are, but it is up to us to educate ourselves so we can educate the next person and we can do better. We need to be the generation to do better. That is it. That is all I'm gonna say to you. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If I sounded angry or mad, I promise you I was not. I just get very passionate when I'm talking about things that matter most to me. So that is all there is to it. I am not mad. I'm disappointed. I'm embarrassed, but I am not mad. Anyways, don't forget to like and comment on this video. Open up a conversation. Let's have a conversation. If you want to debate with me in the comments, you are free to do so. Anyways, I will see you guys on my next video. Thank you guys for joining me on yet another video. If you stay through the end, much love to you and ma'asalam. Bye.